for families. But the most important message that Our Lady has been repeating very often is the Holy Mass. But not only on Sunday. At the time when we were still children, Our Lady said to us visionaries, if you have to choose between seeing me in the apparition or attending the Holy Mass, you simply must choose to attend the Holy Mass. Because during the Holy Mass, my son is with you. In all these years of the apparitions, Our Lady never said, pray and I will give you. But she always says, pray so that I can pray to my son for you. So Jesus is always in the first place. Many of pilgrims who come to Medjugorje believe that we visionaries are privileged. That it is enough just to say a word to us because God will accept our prayers better than the prayers of other people. But that is wrong way of thinking. Because when it comes to Our Lady as Mother, there are simply no privileged children. For her, we are all just her children that she has been choosing for different missions. She chose six of us in order to give the messages. But she chose every one of you. Because in one of her messages of January the 2nd, Our Lady said, dear children, I invited you. Open your hearts, allow me to enter in order to be able to make you become my apostles. But if we can still talk about the privileged ones for Our Lady, the way I understood when I looked at her messages, then we can talk about priests. Because she never said what they should do. She always talks about what we should do for them. She says they do not need you to judge and criticize them. They need your prayers and they need your love. Because God will judge them the way they were as priests. But God will judge you the way you treated your priests. During the apparitions on every second of the month, Our Lady repeats the importance of the priest. For example, when she's blessing us, she always says, I'm giving you my motherly blessing. But the greatest blessing that you can receive on earth is a blessing coming from your priest. When they bless you, it is my son himself blessing you. She also says, do not forget to pray for your shepherds. Their priestly hands are blessed by my son. Our Lady asks from us to bring back the prayer of the rosary in our families. Our Lady says that there is nothing that can unite the family like when you pray together. And she says that parents have great responsibility before their children. Because parents are those who are supposed to put the seeds of faith in their children. And they can do it only if they pray together and if they attend the Holy Mass together. Because children do only what they see in their home. We cannot talk to them about the importance of the Holy Mass if they don't see that the Holy Mass is in the first place for us. We cannot talk to them about the importance of prayer if they don't see us praying. That is why Our Lady says that parents have great responsibility. Our Lady asks from us fasting on Wednesdays and Fridays and bread and water. She doesn't ask fasting from those who are sick, but from those who are really sick. Those people will realize through their own prayer what they can do instead of fasting on bread and water. But if you never prayed the entire rosary every day so far,
Ako niste nikada postili dva dana u tjednu.
If you never fasted twice a week so far.
Ja bih vam preporučila da pokušate kako je Gospa s nama činila u Međugorju.
I would like to recommend you to do the way Our Lady did with us in Međugorje.
Kad se ukazala traže da molimo svaki dan sedam Oče naša, zdravo Marija, slavocu i vjerovanje.
When she appeared, the first thing she asked from us was to pray on a daily basis, creed and then seven times, Our Father, Hail Mary and Glory Be. Sometime after she added one part of the rosary daily and then to fast on Friday. Then she asked for the second part of the rosary. Then even third part of the rosary and then to fast on Wednesday. She was going step by step. You can try to do the same. She's asking for us to go to Holy Confession at least once a month. Because she says that there is no man on earth who doesn't have a need of a monthly confession. She asks the Bible in our families. But when Our Lady gives me the message, she doesn't explain that message to me. Seeing like every one of you, I also have to pray in order to understand what God desires to tell me through that message. So when Our Lady says, bring back the Bible into your families, I believe that we all have a Bible. But Our Lady desires a simple thing. To open the Bible every day, to read a few sentences, it doesn't matter how much. But that the Bible is truly present in our family. Because Our Lady says, the answers to all our questions are hidden in the Bible. This would be, in short, what I personally consider as the most important. And now let's see what you are interested in.